Welcome back, and with us live over the phone is Dr. Rauf Ghafar, our political and economic analyst. Good morning, Dr. Ghafar.
Good morning to you, my dear.
Good morning, sir. We were talking earlier about an expected visit to Sudan by His Excellency the Head of State, President Abdel Fattah el-Sisi. A very important visit with a very important specific timing. Also, it is an official visit to be able to touch on very important fronts. First of all, Ambassador Bassem Radi earlier said that this visit by the President to Sudan is the first of its kind since the formation of the Sudanese Foreign Council. So how do you elaborate on that particular phrase by the official spokesperson?
It is very much, in my opinion, if one of the most important visits, if not the most important visit. I mean, it comes in a very critical time. We know about the problem with the borders, etc., etc., and the aggression of the Ethiopian forces into Sudan, and of course among the dam issue and others. But we have read and we have heard over the last few days about extremely important developments in the relation between the two countries. We have heard about a very high-level visits from different ministries, and I don't want to specify. We heard about an agreement on the military level. I'm talking about a huge transformation and development in the bilateral relation. And I think that we will hear sometime today about very, very important understandings and agreements between the two countries on the on all levels, but particularly on the economic and the military level.
Right. Also, this visit is supposed to highlight the keenness of the joint cooperation, like you kindly pointed out too, and the unification of visions and senses between the two countries regarding different causes of mutual concerns. What are the most pressing different causes of mutual concern, and what is supposed, from your own point of view, the visions, the common visions and stances that are going to be set over the table of negotiations?
Well, I mean, Egypt, Sudan, practically same country, same people. As a matter of fact, we all know we were one country until very recently. So, discussion and talks between the two presidents or the two heads of state is something very normal. But it comes this time particularly in the midst of a lot of events and development occurring in this region. Again, I repeat, the problem with the neighboring country, Sudan, is something unprecedented. We are talking the unilateral decision of Ethiopia regarding the Renaissance Dam, and so many things that needs to be put on the table, and we discussed and agreed upon. And our president said it repeatedly that the security of Sudan is the security of Egypt. The national security of Sudan is not an extension, but it is very much the national security of Egypt. So I am sure they will put their heads together and they will agree on how to confront all the challenges that are presented as one country, not two.
Yes. Well, Dr. Ghaffar, the visit of President Sisi at this timing is also important because this particular visit is expected to witness holding an Egyptian-Sudanese summit during that visit, and as well as bilateral meetings with senior Sudanese officials and businessmen.
Sure. I mean, we are talking a complete change to the better, of course, in the relations between the two countries on all levels and in all domains. So we expect, as I said, a transformation in the type of relations. I mean, now we have heard and read that Sudan is changing the administration system, going back to what it used to be, to decentralize the management of Sudan, and this again is a major step forward in a country as big as Sudan. I'm sure Egypt is giving its blessing.
Right. We also have a certain significance or specific focus over the long time and historic relations or coordination, Egyptian-Sudanese cooperation on different fields, like you earlier said, the military one, the security, the economic, the cultural, I mean, over the frontiers and different challenges, security challenges, economic challenges. I mean, these are fundamental issues that are binding or bonding the two nations. How is that going to change the course of negotiations over issues like the Renaissance Dam, taking same stance and identical stance towards that particular issue?
In my opinion, this visit marks the beginning, as I said, of a new era. It sends a message, a clear message to the whole world that from this day on, Sudan and Egypt are one, and any challenges facing one country is the same challenge facing the other. They will confront together any crises, any challenges, any problems together as one country. And on the military level, of course, and on all other levels, we can consider that Egypt and Sudan, as of today, are fully integrated in one big country that will be standing all together against any challenges that may face.
Right. What about the issues like the Red Sea region, as well as the developments in the Sudanese borders? And is it going to be unfolding some new headlines?
I'm sure. I mean, the presence of President in Egypt following the visit of the Minister of Defense is following a series of meetings and visits. The foreign minister of Sudan was here a couple of days ago. I mean, we can feel a huge thing happening. And I am sure that, as you rightly said, this visit will be the subject of big headlines, maybe by the end of today or tomorrow morning, regarding this regional new force that will emerge, represented by Egypt and Sudan, this area, regarding all matters regional capabilities.
From your own point of view, currently speaking, with all the pandemics, with all the political challenges and the economic ones and the unexpected moves taken by some African countries, what are the most pressing challenges that are facing Egypt and Sudan in the current time and for the coming 3 years?
Today, we are facing two major challenges. It's life or death challenges. First of all, the aggression of Ethiopia over the borders between Ethiopia and Sudan. Mm. This is something completely unacceptable, and will see the end of it very, very soon. Mm. Second, a very pressing, very important and vital is the Renaissance Dam. Ethiopia does not seem to come to any senses, and they don't want any agreements, binding agreements. They want to work on their own. They want to fill it without taking the opinion of anybody, without considering even the interests and of anybody. Egypt now is asking the world community to participate in any negotiations with Africa, with the Ethiopia, made it very clear together with Sudan that they will not, again I repeat, they will not allow the unilateral movement, the filling, the second filling of the dam under any circumstances. These are the issues that will be discussed, not only discussed, but agreed upon definitely, and we will see that Egypt and Sudan will have the same opinion, will have the same point of view regarding these two pressing issues. I mean, you can add to them a lot of regional issues in the Red Sea, a lot of other issues, the bilateral relation on all levels and in all domains between the two countries. But these are two, in my opinion, representing a milestone in the African territory.
Mm. Right. And how is that particular visit with this timing, that very crucial timing, important timing, going to set an impact over the African region politically and economically?
Egypt and Africa has been the relation between Egypt and Africa has been growing on the positive side for the last years. Now we are talking regional, again, this is my opinion, a new regional force that will emerge represented by Egypt and Sudan all together, and they will be an important, they will have an important place as far as the continent is concerned. And of course, any issue that will be tackled by the two countries together as one will certainly have impact on the relation between this particular area of Africa and the rest of the African countries, and will have an impact on all commercial and the other relations in the whole of Africa.
Hopefully. Hopefully, inshallah. Dr. Rauf Ghafar, you're a political and an economic analyst. Would like to thank you so much for talking to us this morning. And with this, we come to the end of this edition of The Breakfast Show for now. Many thanks to all of you who joined us, and you have a beautiful day.